Hello guys, it's Innovative Idea Girl. Welcome back to my channel. I am here today with another video, and in this video I will be showing you three or four school supply ideas. So let's go. So the first thing you're going to need is these containers of paint, and one of them has to be empty, or I mean as much, you just have to have one empty container like this or any other container at all. You will also need a highlighter, a pen, these cotton swabs, and you will need something to write on. So you can write anything you want. For example, if you're just writing something, so if you're just writing something like your channel's name or whatever it is, just trying to, and you want to make sure it's important and you're highlighting it, and then you notice that you made a mistake and then you're like, oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? Well, I've got a quick cure for that. So in your empty container, you want to squeeze out a lemon. I already did that. So you want to have a container of this lemon juice, basically. You want to take your cotton swab and you want to just dip it in there. Just kind of, and then soak it out. And then, wherever you made a mistake, that's where you want to just, you know, kind of spread that out. For example, I meant to highlight my channel name and I accidentally highlighted is. Right. So, all you have to do is put the Q-tip, I mean the lemon juice, over that and it's gone. Did you just see that? So, okay, I'll show you one more time. I can erase anything I want. If I want to erase, idea, just spread it and it's gone. Do you see how cool that is? You can, if you ever make a mistake highlighting and then you're like, oh my gosh, and you do not want to start all over writing everything, all you have to do is take lemon juice and highlight it on. And the good thing about this is it doesn't even spread onto the other paper. It just stays like that. Of course, if you put too much, it's going to happen. So you want to make sure you have a little. And even the least amount of juice you have just makes it go away. And it doesn't. It's not even wet. Your paper is not ruined anywhere. So that was school. That was the school hack number one. So now you see this, you can do anything. You can be writing and highlighting. You don't have to worry about messing up because you always have your lemon juice and your cotton with you. And what I would suggest is if you want to keep your cotton swab with you so you don't lose it, just take a little piece of tape, very skinny. Okay, I got it too fat, no worries. And just sort of, and put it over so that you have it there and you don't have to worry. So now moving on to school hack number two. Let's go. Now for the third craft. For example, if you're reading a book and then you just put in a strip of paper, whatever, and you put it away, then you take it again and then you're trying to find what page it is and you're like, oh my gosh, where's that page? And you're just so confused and then you're like, oh, just can't read it anymore. But I will show you how to make a cute bookmark that's very attractive so you can find out where it is. We're basically gonna make a bookmark like this one right here. Isn't it adorable? I know. So you want the printed side facing up and you are just going to fold the top corners to make sort of a triangle shape and just crease the sides real good. Then what you want to do, you want to cut out that triangle so it goes like this. And now you can draw whatever you want. Let's see, let me do something different this time. Oh, I got an idea. Okay. It's gonna look cute, I hope. I'm not even sure. Okay, so I'm almost finished. And done. Okay. I made a rainbow this time, if you can see it. It looks adorable. But now we need to make sure that this doesn't rip and it's sturdy. So, obviously, we take our tape. First, we stick it in the middle. We stick it right there where the folds were so that it stays more like a bookmark. And you just fold the other sides, the excess. Then you fold the other part that's left out here and you fold it on the inside. And you want to tape out the whole side so it stays sturdy, so that it lives longer, basically. And again, you just fold the excess into it. I'm just gonna do it with this side. And you're done. You have this awesome bookmark that's so attractive. You can mark it on whatever page you were on. And you're good to go. And you can literally see where you left off. And it just, as soon as you open that book, it's already there waiting for you. So, without further ado, let's go on to our next school supply hack. Let's go. So, for the third craft, you will need highlighters or markers, whatever you want to do. So sometimes we're just using a highlighter or a marker, and we're highlighting and we're just getting so bored because you look at that color and you're like, it's so simple. But today I'm going to show you how to change that. First, you want to take any color highlighter. I'm going to take pink. Then you take any other color. I'm going to use purple, and you just want to press the tips of them together. And you switch the purple with a green. And now let's see how that goes. Okay, I am very nervous. I wonder how it's going to look. It actually does not look bad. Okay. It's like a mix of those. And you can do anything you want, and it'll just keep changing and changing and changing and changing and changing for like a long time. And you can actually see the pink and then the purple. It just looks so pretty. It actually... And that way you'll feel more interested in highlighting your notes and it'll be much more fun. And slowly it starts returning to its normal color, so you don't have to worry about ruining your highlighters. This just stays for a little while. Of course the color will stain on, but your highlighter's color will eventually come back. So it is not temporary. So don't worry about that. Now moving on to the next school supply. For this next school supply and the last school supply I'm going to show you here, you take foam and a bottle cap or any kind of cap at all. And you will need markers or a highlighter. So, first I have this foam that actually has the sticky part, so it actually can stick on anywhere. But you can cut it out in any shape to make a stamp. So I am going to make a heart. I want to make sure it's small enough to fit in. I hope it fits in, so let me just do that. I'm not even sure. Maybe I might have to try on another one. Okay, I'm just going to cut this heart a little because it is not perfect. and is not fitting in. I'm going to take my time cutting this heart here to make sure it is perfect. Okay, now it's perfect. Peel off that sticky part, or you can glue it on with a hot glue. Then you take any color, for example, green, you color it, and then you have a stamp. So, this can make your notes and your letters so much more fun to use. You can write any letter to your friends. Take that stamp and just stamp it on like. Okay, and whenever you're done with that, you can color it again. And press that stamp on and look at that heart right there. Do you see that heart? It's actually a mix of green and purple. I mean, I know it doesn't look that great if you see it from the camera, but it actually looks really cool. And now you have your own mini stamps. You can make so many different kinds of these, circles, triangles, take them to school, and obviously you keep a highlighter, color it in whenever you want, and just start using it for fun. I just am loving this. And when it fades away, it looks so much cooler. So guys, this was the last school supply. I hope you enjoyed all these school supplies. I hope they will be useful to you. And I hope you enjoyed them, the main point. And I would really appreciate it if you could subscribe to my channel and give me a big thumbs up. I would really appreciate that and like that very much. So if you can, please do that. And I will see you on the next video. Bye, guys.